Ooh, child,
this song right here.
Things are gonna get easy.
Goes out to all my young sisters that's caught in the struggle. Ooh, child, of being things a young mother. Brighter. I got love for you. Keep your head up. A sportsman, a former chairman of an academic staff union, a consultant of the World Health Organization, UNICEF, UNESCO, a professor of institutional.
This university. We thank you for this blessed day. We thank you for this gathering. We thank you for everything about this university. Lord, you know why we are here, and we pray thee to oversee the affairs of this inaugural lecture.
Amen.
We pray that at the end, we will have cause to glorify your holy name for all you must have done for us here. These and many other blessings we ask for in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please be seated. Deputy Vice Chancellor of Administration is seated at the right hand side of the Vice Chancellor. He is Professor Jude Agu. Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic is Professor Onsebe Agu. The Registrar of this University. The one who taught me this job, because he was here as Public Relations Officer of the University for many, many years, and I'm still learning from him, the Registrar of the University, Sir Chris Adamaigu. The Provost College of Medicine is Professor Felix Okoku. Professor Mrs. Emma Akunsen is of the Faculty of Natural Sciences, Department of Microbiology. She delivered the 51st inaugural lecture. Professor V.A. Omaro, Faculty of Arts, Department of English, is the 2nd inaugural lecturer. May I hand over to the registrar to take us and to celebrate the 54th inaugural lecture series of Amusali University Ekoma, to be delivered by Professor Sivanus Hosen Obu, that will judge with you on this occasion. On the topic, nutritional needs, view of waste to wealth, and the endless search for animal feed raw materials. And presiding over this occasion, Vice Chancellor of our great university, Professor I.A. Odumawu. It is therefore my honor and respect to formally invite Vice Chancellor to declare the ceremony. Welcome, Vice Chancellor.
By the power of God of me, as Vice Chancellor of Amusali University, I hereby declare the 54th inaugural lecture open. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Your Excellency, the Comrade Governor of Edo State, in absentia. Your Excellencies, serving and former governors here present. Senators, serving and former present here. Executive Secretary of National Universities Commission, Commissioner for Higher for Education, Edo State, other commissioners serving and former here present, His Royal Majesty the Oba of Benin, His Royal Majesty the Onoje of Eboma, other Royal Fathers here present, my Lord Spiritual and Temporal. The Acting Chairman is on West Local Government Council. Other Acting Chairmen, serving and former present. The Chancellor of Amusali University Ekoma. The Pro-Chancellor and Chairman of Governing Council, AAU. He was here a few while ago. He had a reason to leave. Other members of the Governing Council, former Vice Chancellors of AAU present, principal officers of Amusali University,
distinguished members of Senate of Ambrosale University, members of Congregation of Ambrosale University, members of Convocation of Ambrosale University, distinguished guests, very valuable staff of Ambrosale University, Ekoma, wonderful students of Ambrosale University, Ekoma, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you all to this 54th inaugural lecture to be delivered by one of our very erudite professors, Professor Sylvanus Obo. It gives me great delight to welcome you all to this august occasion, which incidentally is taking place in August. You can see that it's a very rare coincidence. It gladdens my heart also to actually say that I'm presiding over this inaugural lecture as the Vice Chancellor of Ambrosale University. And this is the first inaugural lecture I'm chairing as Vice Chancellor. The first inaugural lecture that was held here was presided over by the Deputy Vice Chancellor Administration, Professor Jude Agu. I thank all of you who were present that day. It was a historic day, having taken place on the day this auditorium was commissioned. All glory goes to Almighty God. The 54th inaugural lecture is to be delivered by Professor Sylvanus Obo of the Department of Animal Science, Faculty of Agriculture, with the topic Nutritionist View of Waste to Wealth and the Endless Search for Animal Feed Raw Materials. I must congratulate the 54th inaugural lecturer, Professor Obo, for this milestone achievement. I also congratulate his family, the wonderful wife here, the Department of Animal Science, and the entire Faculty of Agriculture for producing the 54th inaugural lecture. First professor to deliver an inaugural lecture in the faculty, and the first in the Department of Animal Science. It's very historic that after that gap, today, our lecturer is coming from that faculty. I never venture at least an academic into the professorial chair. He separates the boys from the men. Today, Obo is joining the team of the men. He shows to the world that they are what they have been professing educationally and otherwise, as a pointer to the academic maturity of the university. In light of the above, this is in line with our vision to reposition this university as one of the 10 best in Nigeria. We will continue to say this. We will say it until it materializes, and it will materialize. I therefore enjoy professors here to present their inaugural lectures, to become very active in their research activities, and be prepared to take their turn. Because are going to receive their medals today. This is an innovation of this administration. We believe strongly that any professor that delivers his doctoral lecture must be given a medal. And that has been happening in some other universities. And today, we are demonstrating it, and we are taking it in retrospect. The last 10 we received today. By next month, when we are having under the parliament, the other received 10 we also receive, until we clear all the backlog. Since I took office 3 months ago in the mental strikes, 12 professors and 20 readers have been announced in the last 3 months.
which I'm sure by the next council meeting they will all be ratified. The monthly prayer program at AAU Praise has been held every month. This leadership believes that AAU must be fully handed over to God if we are to make the needed progress. And on our assumption, we also introduced another aspect of our mission to ensure that everybody is healthy. And therefore, we have also introduced the monthly health walk. And this health walk takes place at the last Friday of every month. If you are not participating, I want to invite you that come this Friday, tomorrow, we are going to have another health walk. It is to make you fit. It is to make your system work well. We don't want to preside over sudden deaths, which has become common in many places because of the fact that our lifestyle and activity has led to a lot of clogging of our blood vessels. One of the people where he told us that anywhere he goes to deliver a lecture and he goes back, something positive must happen in that camp. And not quite long after he left, the main Epoma road was flagged off for construction. So I think the prophecy has come to pass.
I also want to announce that that is the first phase of what Denmark Construction wants to do here. They also intend to build staff quarters, big gradually and different units within this campus. Also recently, all these are in progress, and I'm sure by the time we come for the next November lecture, we will tell you the progress we have made on this year. AAU must be among the 10 best universities in Nigeria. There is collaboration with First Bank now to set up an internet banking center in the university, and maybe to bring back full banking services after a trial in the first one. An MOU is also to be signed to Zenith Bank to build the mega cluster of ATM in the university with at least 8 functional vending machines, so that the problem of epileptic reception will be a thing of the past. Glow has moved into campus just yesterday. They did the groundbreaking ceremony to put the underground cables that will connect Glow through the fiber optics, the broadband internet service, to the administrative block, and thereafter it will be sent to all other parts of the campus. We are also expecting that of MTN very soon. Except 6. I'm happy to announce that the shortfall in theory of those three programs have already been remedied. We are still working on the other three, so that NUC will come back for registration even before the close of admission in November. So that we don't want to lose any of these programs. I expected to mention here that the state government has not abandoned the university, as was reported in Banda of 2016. We have published an agenda in which we corrected the wrong impression. But I want to state clearly that before that application time was done, the administrative office sent $100 million to this university to help in the accreditation assistance. The fact that some of our program did not meet the requirement does not mean that the government has abandoned a. I want to appeal that we should not play politics with Ambrosian University. It's too dear to us to be dragged into the dirty pages of newspapers on things that are not correct. We are also saying that as soon as NUC visits us, perhaps when we are giving the next central election, we'll give you the updates of those visits. Recently, I'm from the University of Oklahoma, won the first prize in an international competition organized by their campus students, by an international group of finance professionals to this university. Workers have already moved into sites for building fish ponds, piggeries, poultry, packing of cows. It is interesting to note that the lecture topic today talks about animal feeds, and Professor Obo is an expert in this area and is the director of those programs I just mentioned. He is a member of Bender State. Is going to be honored from now on every year. Therefore, my joy to announce that we have to have been celebrated annually. We will cross the road.
Yes.
As I express my profound gratitude to the Commonwealth Government of Houston for his love and unfailing support to this university. He has continued to play his part despite the economic downfall of all over the country. I also express my thanks to the chairman and members of the Voting Council for their cooperation, wisdom, and guidance. I extend my thanks to the trade unions, ASU, FANU, NATS, and NASA for their cooperation and understanding thus far.